Hey guys, Brian Parnell here, and as I promised in my email yesterday that I would show you a couple of things that I do so I haven't got to go and create videos. And then what I actually do with those videos is I will put them into a silo fashion, okay, and then put them into a playlist, okay, and that playlist will have my keyword, okay. The description of all of the videos that I upload using Livestream Genius will allude to the main keyword I'm trying to rank for. And something else I wanted to actually say is this is really powerful for local. Okay, you can put in your NAP into the description of the video and use clients location for the live stream, okay, equals, that needs to be equals real local SEO power, okay. Now guys, what I was going to do is I was going to offer this as a bonus. I was going to do some bonus training to for everybody that bought Livestream Genius through my link, okay. I'm the only one selling it at the moment, so you know, that's, I've got exclusive rights to it because I was one of the beta testers and I've helped make it the great tool that it is, and I've helped the guys get the product to launch, if you like. So you know, I've got the exclusive rights. Now I've gone on about siloing videos lots of times before, okay, and it is really powerful. But you can actually, those videos that you upload, you can make them as unpublished, okay, then link them to another video, that video can be unpublished, link them to another video, that video can be unpublished, and then link that one to your main money keyword, but all of the time doing these if you're in the local, okay. Or make sure that you use your keyword in the description, okay, for your silo videos and the playlist, and you can add them to a playlist, and that playlist you can either make that public or hidden, okay, or unpublished as well. I think they call it unpublished as well. This is real YouTube ranking power, okay. And then if you just go and get some social signals to all of those YouTube videos, go to Fiverr and get some video embeds, okay, you can dominate, all right. And but for, you know, for local, make sure you are doing this. This is really powerful, okay. So let me first show you Creative Commons. I'm going to search for Creative Commons because I can't remember if it's .org or .com. So Creative Commons search, and then it should come up with the website. And it's search Creative Commons, okay, so that's the URL. It's search.creativecommons.org, so it is .org. And in here, guys, you can use things that you're free to modify, adapt, or build upon. Well, you know, if you untick that, okay, you can even, if you're very risky, you can even untick the, you know, free to use for commercial purposes, okay. But let's... I don't know. I'm just going to use plumbing. Okay, just plumbing for an example. Oh, my bad. I want to go to YouTube, and it brings up lots of videos. Okay, loads and loads of videos that are Creative Commons, and you can also do this within YouTube itself. Okay, now I'm not going to go through and bore you with loads of things, but what I want to show you is two different ways to actually download the video. Okay, I've got a plugin called Video Download Helper. Okay, Video Download Helper in Firefox, and it will download the video. Now what I want is I want to make sure that these videos are 720, but if I can find something that's 1080p, all the better. So this one's 720, okay. Now when you've got that video like this, you come up to this little plugin use the drop down and you just take the first one, okay, 1280 by 710, because it's a 710 video, that's the maximum, okay? Now, there are some ways to actually make this do conversions. So if it's a bigger video, let's see if I can find a bigger video. When I say bigger, I mean at 1080p, that's what I'm looking for. How annoying is that? Gotta watch the poxy video. Sorry if you can hear it coming through, I think I turned off system sound. Sorry, there, 1080p. So this one here is 1080p. Okay, now if I come up to here now, we can see that we can download it as 1080p, however it's ADP. Okay, and for some reason, I don't know why, the conversion tool, because when I click on this now, it will say that it needs a conversion tool. Oh, it might actually just do it. Let's see. Maybe it's working now. Okay, that's worked, and it's come down at 1080p. How awesome is that? Now, I didn't, for whatever reason, oh, it's not working on my Mac. That's right, it's not working on my Mac. But if you can't get that to work, because you've got to download a little conversion tool, and just follow the instructions. If you go to here and you click onto the 1080p, anything that says ADP, it will say that you need a conversion tool, follow these instructions, install what you need to install, and you know, jobs are good. Problem that I have is that the conversion sometimes just, the conversion tool just didn't work. So what I did was I found, if I go to, what's it called? It's called J Downloader 2. Okay, and then you can just copy the YouTube URL, go to this software. It takes quite a while to open sometimes, especially if I'm doing a video. There you go. So it will pick up the video automatically, and literally, if I go to here now, copy, come to here, it's already added that in. Okay, coast to coast, this is the plumb, that's that video. Okay, and then you can come down here, click on start downloads, and it will download it, okay, at 1080p, which is awesome, because you can see it actually says here 1080p, and then you can use all of those videos. So I just want to exit this. You can use all these videos in a silo. Okay, now if you're a little bit confused about what I mean by silo, please by all means go to my YouTube channel. And if I bloody hell, I've got so many videos in here, I can't remember which one it is, but let's see if I can find the video. Here we go. So even though I did this in February 2014, this still works like gangbusters. Okay, I've got it muted so you won't be able to hear anything. Alright, and this is the video. Okay, so that's the URL, and you can watch, you know, watch the video at your own pace. But go through, by all means, go through my YouTube videos, and you know, because I think there's another ranking tip that continues after this that you might also like. But it's basically, you just link one video to the next one, to the next one, to the next one, until you get to your top money video. Now, what I was testing a couple of years ago, last year, was having the video as unpublished. So when you have your video, so let's go to Video Manager here a minute. You can see over here, this says public, okay? But you can actually come into here, come down to here, and you can have that as unpublished or as private. But if you do it as private, you've got to add somebody that you want to you know, have in your circles, but I always just share it with myself, so it's only me that can see it. But if you have it unlisted, it still passes all of that juice, but it, nobody can see it unless they've actually got the URL of that video, okay? But it still passes the juice through, still send all your signals and your social signals, your video embeds for blogging, and that's, you know, just really powerful for videos, and it gives that power and passes that power on, okay? So you can see here that I've actually linked to another video, and I've also linked to my main page, okay? Now, I'm going to just show you quickly how to create, how to add videos to a playlist. So say you come to your video, you click on to add to, okay? And you can see here I've got lots and lots of different playlists, and then my keywords, so Livestream Genius, and I've got my, all my videos in Livestream Genius, Watch Later, and, you know, loads of different other ones. And regardless of what, you know, you just put your keyword in there, your main keyword that you want your main keyword to rank for, your main video to rank for, and your main website to rank for, okay, because it also has a push-on effect to that. As long as you've got the, you know, the URL of your website in your description, it all has a big impact. And especially if people are watching this video and then clicking through to your website, all the better. And one way to force people to click, two ways to force people to click through to your website: when you're logged in and you've got your video, you've got annotations, okay, you can go in, click on annotations, add an annotation, okay, I don't want to mess this video up, click on to link, choose associated website. If you haven't got this option here, associated website, you just need to go into your channel settings, and then you can put your website in, okay? So if it's your client's channel, you can go in and you can then, you know, associate the website, and, you know, you might need to have one of those HTML files that Google gives to you, so they know that you own the website and all that kind of stuff, and yeah, and that's how you do it, okay? And then there's also cards, okay? Select your language, how strange, hold on, have I not go to cards. Now cards also work on mobile, okay? So you would click on add new card, okay, link, and then you can do it to your approved associated website, and you can have something in there, make it, you know call us today, or, you know, visit our website for our, you know, your exclusive 25% discount off your first order, or for your free ebook, whatever it is that you're giving away. So you're forcing people over to your website, and then when people get to that website, that's traffic to the website. So as long as they're engaged on your website and they're taking an action, that will be a positive ranking signal, and it all just helps with your SEO. So, you know, this is just all free stuff, but I just want to show you all of this because Livestream Genius is another way to help you get that extra boost. So if I open up Livestream Genius a minute, and I apologize that it's not open, I realized that I promised that I was going to do a video. I've just got back from the gym, I'm soaking wet because it's raining outside, and I walked to the gym and back just so I get an extra 20-30 minutes of exercise, and I'm sat here in my office chair dripping all over the leather, so it's probably ruining it, but I wanted to get this out to you, so apologies that it wasn't already open. So if I click on simple projects, click on add new project, and then where it says video location, you can actually put in your client's address, including the postcode, okay? That is extremely, extremely powerful, and it will rank your Google Plus locals, you know, the Google Plus local guys. I know I've got lots of new people on my list at the moment who are new to, you know, trying to get into local marketing and stuff. But if we type in Plumber Birmingham, this stuff, so this is Yahoo, bloody Yahoo, I don't know why it's coming up with Yahoo, but you know, it helps get you into this box for Google. So if we go into Google a minute, just show you that. What did I type in? Plumber. Birmingham. Don't know why Birmingham's so far down. It seems it's the second biggest city in the UK. It should be at the top. But this is the map box. So to help get your clients into here, using Livestream Genius and putting in their address into this spot here will help push that up. And then in the description, you also have the address, okay? And the address, telephone number, and website, okay? So it's business name. So NAP stands for name, address, phone number. But to help your rankings, to help your clients rank here, okay, you need business name, address, telephone number, and website. Just, you know, just a naked URL to their website, and that helps. So that's why, you know, if you can get more directory listings than your client's competitors, you can rank in here all day long. Now, I know that I let something lapse, something that did like an annual submission for directories. So I don't think I'm showing, here I am, look at that, there I am. So I'm still in the map, okay? So even though I let something lapse, I'm still showing in the top three for SEO Birmingham, which is pretty fucking awesome if you ask me, all right? Okay guys, so I'm gonna close that. I'm trying to give you as much information as possible. I like to, you know, I'm one of these people that I do try to give value. And you know, I could say, oh, well, you have to buy it to get all of this kind of stuff, but I want to give you this so you can actually, you know, see how powerful this software actually is, okay? So, Creative Commons videos, okay? You can use them. You put your keyword in your description, and you put them in a playlist that is your main keyword. If for local marketing, you can put your NAP, name, address, phone number into the description. You can also put it as the location of the live stream, which gives your clients even more power. You won't believe that it works, but it really does. And then unpublished videos, they're still powerful. So if you don't want your clients, you know, you might go and use loads of Creative Commons videos that I showed you. You might want to say, right, we're going to do 20. So you're going to go down and you're going to take 20 of the videos. You're going to make them all unpublished, because they're not your clients' videos, and they might be talking about Alabama or something that, and you're not in Alabama, or you know, it doesn't have to be a client who is a local either. It can be a client who, you know, you do e-commerce for, whatever SEO you do for them. This stuff really, really works. It's really powerful. Okay, so that's all I'm going to say on this today. You know, I do really urge you to get Livestream Genius. Yes, it doesn't look as pretty as other softwares out there, but it works better. All right, the guys were like, oh, you know, we need to make it look better. I'm like, don't get all hung up on making it look better. It serves the purpose. It's got all the fields that you need in it to fill in, and you know, you can do an exit bumper image. So you know, an image right at the end that says something like, you know, click here for your exclusive discount, click here, or phone here, or whatever it is that you want, and you can make that stay for 30 seconds. And then they give you an audio file, or you can put your own audio file in there that is up to is 30 seconds or longer. So it means that exit bumper stays there for 30 seconds, meaning that when the video ends, it doesn't just shut off and then show somebody else's video. It stays there with this nice big exit bumper that says, you know, call us now, click here now, whatever it is. Okay, and then you can click through to your website, get a phone call, whatever. All right. Okay guys, so I hope you found that extremely useful, because you know, I'm trying to give you some different ways that you can use this software. And I really, really do think that, I know for a fact, there's so many people on my list that are, you know, in the local arena, SEOs, into e-commerce, that are affiliate marketers. If you can't see the power of this, then I don't know what else there is that you can actually see the power in. All right. Okay then guys, take care for now. Cheerio.